Hi, Michael G0POT here, and this week I've been playing with the W4OP magnetic loop kindly loaned to me by Kanga UK.
This is a small transmit receive loop designed to provide continuous tuning from 40 to 10 meters, and with an add-on it also gives approximately 800 kilohertz of coverage at 6 meters. The physics and propagation pattern for 6 meters is a little different than the lower bands, so for the purpose of this review I will be focusing on the 40 to 10 meter version. The loop comes in two flavours, manual tuning and a remote tuning variant. I have the remote tuning variant, and I have to say, for the small additional cost, I really like this feature. Manual tuning is dead simple, but as you approach and withdraw from the loop to turn the tuning knob, you affect the resonance of the aerial. This can make the process of tuning for peak noise much harder. Loops can be used horizontally, but I don't think the W4OP loop is really designed with that in mind. Let's look at the specifications. The loop is about 112 centimetres in diameter, that's about 44 inches, and weighs in at about 1.9 kilograms or 4 pounds. It's actually quite heavy, which is great for stability, but a disadvantage if you want to go portable and have to carry it. The loop packs down to a small diameter of about 53 centimetres or 21 inches, and a carry case is available as an optional extra. The main loop is made from 1 centimetre or 3/8 inch diameter heliax, which is pretty rigid, and I have to say it holds its shape really well over time. The ends appear to be terminated with silver plated PL259 plugs, which will aid in keeping the loop impedance low. The loop is supported by a strut that comes in three parts, each about 37 centimetres or 14.5 inches long, helping to keep the carry size small if you want to go portable. The bottom strut screws into the main tuning unit, and the top accepts a support attached to the loop. The HF coupling loop is 21 centimetres or 8.25 inches across and comes with a mounting that slides over the strut and a thumb screw to allow height adjustment. It's fitted with a BNC socket which suits the QRP nature of the loop. I confess I was a little unclear how to position this coupling loop from the instructions, but by attaching the aerial analyzer I was able to see the effects of raising and lowering the coupling loop and to find the optimum position for it. The base tuning unit, which contains the tuning capacitor and in this case the driver motor and reduction gearbox, is 160 by 80 by 85 millimeters. That's 6.25 by 3.18 by 3.38 inches. This is where the bulk of the weight of the aerial is. It has a common SO259 socket for one side of the main loop and separate SO259s on the other side of the box depending on whether you're using the HF loop or the 6 meter loop. On the manually tuned version there's a tuning knob at the capacitor, but on this automatic version there's simply an SMA socket for the controller unit. The base comes with four stabilizer feet that can be folded under the unit for transportation, then spread out for stability. The automatic version of the loop comes with this remote tuning controller, which has a 7.5 meter or 25 foot cable, enabling you to sit some distance from the loop. The cable is nice and lightweight, but be careful how you store it as it knots and twists easily. The controller unit is 90 by 65 by 28 millimeters or 3.5 by 2.5 by approximately 1 inch. It takes a PP3 9 volt battery and has a single toggle switch and a latching push button switch. With these you can tune up or down using the toggle switch and tune fast or slow using the push button switch. When in slow mode, the red LEDs light. The unit also has two green LEDs to indicate when the end stops of the tuning capacitor have been reached. Very small movements can be tricky, but by practicing, especially with an aerial analyzer, you quickly learn an efficient approach. Magnetic loop power handling is typically dictated by the variable capacitor, and LNR rate this loop at 15 watts for CW or SSB, or 10 watts for higher duty cycle digital modes.
Right, let's make it. See how long roughly it takes.
Setup literally takes just a few minutes. So, thumbs up on the quality of the build and simplicity to get it on air. So what's it actually like to use? Firstly, it's very convenient in terms of size. I've used this in the house, in the garden, and out portable for SOTA. I love the remote tuning unit. I wasn't immediately sold on it, but I have an Alex loop with a manual tuning knob and have been thinking about how to automate that already. It makes it easier to tune and is much, much more convenient as you tune around the bands, as you don't have to keep returning to the aerial to retune it. If you haven't used a magnetic loop before, then you need to know that they are super narrow band and need to be retuned when you move more than a few kilohertz. This has an added benefit though, that it attenuates signals above and below you. As with all loops, it can be a struggle to tune the dip to be spot on your chosen operating frequency. I overcome this by using the internal ATU in my radios to overcome any slight mismatch, but this does mean that if you hear a station and want to reply, it takes some time to get tuned. An alternative approach when simply calling is to tune the loop roughly to the desired frequency and then rely on tuning the radio to find the dip in SWR.
And there we have, the W4OP loop. I think that took under a minute. Very quick and easy. And then of course taking it apart is just the reverse. We have it. So what's it actually like in use? Well, I'm on a SOTA summit, so let's give it a go. Right, we're going to QSY to 30 metres now. And I've tuned to the bottom of 30 metre band where I know there's going to be some noise to tune in, so I should hear the noise pick up. If I can hear it above the helicopters. So I've got a military helicopter buzzing me, using the top of the hill, I think, as a reference point. So let's get tuning. I shouldn't be far off. There it is. So let me tune up to where I want to be. I want to be a little bit higher. Turn the volume down, sorry. That's really good SWR on 30 meters. I'm right down at 1:1. I might have to put headphones on just to overcome this bloody helicopter. He won't leave me alone. Leave that pile up and summarise my thoughts. The W4OP loop delivered some good contacts. It packs down into a small size and is quick and simple to set up and tear down. Its small operating size makes it suitable for indoors, perhaps when operating from a hotel, and I've used it in the house, in the garden, on top of a car while parked and out portable. The build quality is very good and there's some really nice attention to detail in the design and construction. Tuning can be a challenge and you will definitely need some way of measuring your SWR to check that you're tuned.
Having an ATU available can also be an advantage. Tuning up to respond to another station calling CQ can take time, but for an operating style where you choose a frequency and stay put, like SOTA, the W4OP loop is perfect. If you're going to want to tune around, then the remotely tuned version of the loop that I've reviewed here is worth the extra cost. My thanks go to Dennis from Kanga for the loan of the loop. If you're interested, based in the UK or Europe, please contact Kanga in the first instance. Otherwise, for those of you in the Americas, please contact LNR Precision. Please subscribe to the channel for more amateur radio content, and whatever you're up to, get out there and enjoy your radio.